Welcome again, everyone. In this lecture, I want to show you how to install WordPress on your IIS server, and I will show you the power of the Web Platform Installer tool. Just open your server node and click on Web Platform Installer that we installed in the last lectures. Just double-click to open it and wait a little bit for it to load. Alright, now simply search for WordPress. And here it is. This is the WordPress application. Click on Add and simply click Install. Now it will ask you for the prerequisites. It says we need MySQL and it is not installed. Just select the password of the root and everything will be configured automatically. This is the root password of MySQL. Just put it here and click Continue. And it will show you that it will install WordPress with MySQL for Windows. Just click I accept. And now just wait for the installation to finish. It's very simple. As you can see, this is the power of the Web Platform Installer. If you want to do this manually, you have to download the MySQL connectors, MySQL SDKs, MySQL for Windows, install them and get the WordPress from its website, install them and configure them and so on. This will be done automatically using the Web Platform Installer. For that, it's very important to install it on your IIS server. Now just wait a little bit for the installation to finish. Wonderful! The installation is finished and now we are in the configuration section. Just select here new website and give it a website name. Let's say My WordPress. And this is the website name. Let's say WordPress. Let's name it WP. And let's set the physical path to my computer, C drive, inetpub, make new folder here, and let's say WordPress. And now let's click OK. And set the bindings here. The IP address is all unassigned and port 80. And let's name the host name as www.mywp.com. So this is my host name. I will put this in the host file as I showed you in the lecture where we installed our first website. Now just open Notepad, run as administrator, and let's open the host file. It's in the C drive. Windows, System 32, drivers, etc. Click all files and here's the hosts file. And now I will get this host name and paste it down here, 127.0.0.1. And here we are. Let's save it and close this and click continue. And here we have to set some authentication keys that WordPress uses. You can use any phrases for now. Let's say I will put this phrase 13 underscore at WordPress and let's copy it. Copy this here and here. Just copy the security keys, salt, and click on continue. And the configuration will now start. As you can see, the installation is very simple using the Web Platform Installer. Let's wait a little bit now. And awesome. As you can see, it shows you the password of your database, the username and the password. You can save these so you can use them later. Just put them somewhere else on your notepad or any file and click on finish. Very nice. As you can see, the browser will open automatically and this is my website. mywp.com is opened automatically and this is the WordPress installation. Click continue and here the site title, the username and so on. You can continue the installation and start using WordPress using your IIS server. Thank you for following and see you in another lecture.